Hi, I'm Dr. Daniel Cantor, and once again, for the third time, not the last time, but for the third time, I'm here with Ashley and with her doctor, Dr. Ed Fox. So we've talked about the partnership that we have with the patient and with the physician, but sometimes the patient and physician together decide that maybe we have to think about disability. Why don't you tell us, first from a patient's point of view, when do you start having those thoughts? When is the right time? When is the wrong time? And then we'll hear from you about how you help your patients go through that. So what do you think, Ashley?
Well, when I figured it out was kind of like when I started to have to use like voice recognition programs on the computer, like Dragon Dictation, so I could talk to it and it would type for me. My fine motor skills are not so good. So that's why I kind of noticed, you know, how am I supposed to have a job if I can't even use my hands properly? And then I've discussed it with Dr. Fox, and we're actually going through a process right now after being denied a couple times. So I do have a lawyer with that, though, and my lawyer has sent some information to him as well.
Okay, great. So from your perspective, when a patient decides on disability, when do you direct them to do it? Do you take a big role? Do you fill out the paperwork? What happens with that?
The important aspect for the physician within the role of determining disability is documentation. And so what we need to do, and frankly doctors need to do this better, is ask those important questions about what is it about your particular job that you're unable to do? What is it about your normal daily activities that you're unable to do? Physical therapists play a role in this. A number of other individuals can help with this, but it ends up being pretty much what the doctor says in the notes that go towards whether a person is accepted as having disability or not. It's not what the attorney says, and it's not actually what the doctor fills out on the forms for the attorney. It's what's documented in the medical notes over time. And the important aspect is to figure out when the onset time was for disability, inability to do certain daily activities, and also to be able to put a very firm physical examination correlate with it so that there is more than just the subjective what you're hearing from the patient, but something objectively you can put on the chart that will support that claim.
Okay. Well, so that really helps us understand it, because although we like to avoid disability as much as possible, sometimes we have to invoke disability and the American with Disabilities Act and figure that out. And that's where it's important to work with your physician. Because if you just give us the forms at the last moment when you're walking away, that's not the same as us filling out the forms together, but us also documenting correctly. Documentation is really key to what we do. We have to be better about it, but you have to be more patient with us and help us by giving us that information.
I do actually come in, I have actually talked about it before on previous conferences on my video blogs about how to prepare for a doctor's office. And, you know, I do make sure I have all of my medications, all of my symptoms, you know, all my medication list, my symptoms, any side effects to the medications, how I've been feeling, any new symptoms, how long they last, things like if you have to be, I try and emphasize you really have to be open with your doctor and tell them what's going on if you feel, if you want to get treated properly. Because, you know, like I said before, a lot, even the embarrassing symptoms, because I was referred to a urologist and I'm 24 years old. You just got to suck it up and tell your doctor about it.
Okay, great. Well, thank you guys so much for joining us. I love seeing this partnership, and we'll see you next year. Thank you.